This is our project, single board computer based secure data transmission. Emerging new technologies and having fast internet make information to distribute all over the world easily and thriftily. This made people to worry about their privacy and works. This technography provides methods that users can hide their information within another information that make them difficult to recognize by foe. So in this project, we are proposing a method of steganography called polynomial equations hash least significant bit technique. Objectives of our project: provide undetectability of hidden data. A human eye cannot visualize that data is hidden on the cover object. It prevents hijacking the data from the unknown persons. Next, to provide high capacity of the hidden data means in a cover object, the amount of secret data must be hidden must be more. Next, to improve the perceptual transparency means after hiding process, the stego object must be same as the cover object. This is the block diagram of single board computer based secure data transmission. This is the embedding process. Here, the payload. The payload is the data which we are going to transmit. Now, we are using here a pseudo random sequence and we are performing XOR operation on the payload. So, we get a coded data here. Now, the coded data is given to the single board computer. Single board computer is a complete computer built on a single circuit board with microprocessors, memory, input-output and other features required for a functional computer. Here, we are using Intel Computer Stick single board computer, which is a new generation computer on a stick device. The compute stick is essentially a complete PC, but in the compact form of a slightly large pen drive. It connects to your TV via HDMI port. Now, along with coded payload here, we are giving the cover object to the single board computer. The cover object may be audio or image file in which we are going to hide the data. By using the polynomial equation generator, we are generating the polynomial equations. The use of the polynomial equations here is to find the locations in the cover object in which we are going to hide. Now, the resultant of this embedding process is the stego object. Now, we will go for the extracting process. Extracting process is exactly the opposite as the embedding process. Now, here we are giving the stego object to the single board computer along with the polynomial equations which we have used during the embedding process. So the resultant here is the cover object and the coded payload. Now we are performing XOR operation with the pseudo random sequence which we have used during the embedding process. So the resultant data will be exactly same as the data which we have transmitted. Now I am going to show the results of the project. Here we are taking two systems, one is transmitter and the other is receiver. This is the program for embedding process in the transmitter system. Now, I am going to run this program. We get a graphical user interface of the transmitter here. Now, we will select the cover object as image and we will change the number of equations orders and the coefficients here. Now, we have given the number of equations and order of the equation and all the coefficients of the two equations. And this is the payload. This is KEC. We are going to hide this data. Now, read the cover object. We are selecting the transmitter.jpg as cover object. Now, we are going to embed this data into this cover object. So, this is the stego object. And we will send this stego object to the system 2, that is the receiver. Now, this is the system 2, that is receiver. Now, this is the program for the receiver. That is the extracting process we are going to do here. Now, we are going to run this program. This is the graphical user interface for the receiver. And we have to give the same number of equations, order and coefficients of the polynomial equations which we have used during the embedding process. Now I have entered all the values of the coefficients and now I have to receive the stego image. Now, this is the received image which we have transmitted, that is transmitter.jpg. Now we have to retrieve the message from this image. So this is the original payload which we have transmitted, that is this is KEC. Now if we give other polynomial equations here other than which we have used during the embedding process, we will not retrieve the original message. Instead of this, we will get some garbage values. In the same way, we can use audio file or video file as cover object and we can transmit the data from one place to other place in a secured format. Thank you. Now I am implementing the whole project using two intersticks. Let us consider this intersstick as transmitter intersstick. I have connected this intersstick to the PC by using a HDMI connector. And now externally I have added a keyboard and a mouse so that this intersstick will work as a complete CPU for this PC. Now I have created an app for transmitter and now I am going to open that app. We will get the GUI transmitter app like this. Now I have entered the number of equations and order of the equation and also the coefficients of the two equations here. And I have selected the cover image as image. Now I have to select the cover object. Now I am taking the cover object as transmitter image. Now I am giving the data to be hided, that is coupon. Embed this data into this cover object. Now it is embedded and we got the Stego object here. Now we have to send this to the receiver. So we are clicking send. Now in the same way at the receiver end we are connecting an intersstick to the monitor and I have externally connected a keyboard and a mouse to this intersstick. So this complete connection will work as a complete PC. Now this is the app we have created for receiver. I am opening this. Now I have entered all the values which we have entered during the transmission process and we also entered the IP address of the transmitter system and we clicked on the receive the Stego image. So we have received the Stego image here. Now we have to retrieve the message. So this is the transmitted original message we have received here.